Good morning, everyone. We'll have the last part of the discussion on projection of planes. So far we have discussed some principles of projection, how to draw the projection of planes, and later we discussed when the plane surface is inclined to HP, how to draw the projection of planes. Now in this discussion, what we will do is we will see if planes are inclined to VP, how to draw such kind of questions. Okay. The first question, a set square 30 degrees by 60 degrees of long side 100 mm long, longest side is 100 mm, is in VP and 30 degrees inclined to HP while its surface is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Draw its projections. Now here two angles are there. One is 30 degrees inclined to HP and 45 degrees to VP. Now we have to see what is the surface inclination. Here the longest side, which is in VP, is at an angle of 30 degrees to HP while the surface is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. So it is surface is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. So first thing what we have to do, we have to keep it parallel to VP. Okay, that is the first step. If the surface is inclined to VP or the object is resting on VP, first step is we'll keep the object parallel to VP and then start drawing. Now if the plane is parallel to VP, the true shape you will see in front view. So first step is to draw the front view, then to draw the top view. So this is a 30 degrees, here it is 30 degrees and here it is 60 degrees, and the length of this side is 100 mm. So it is A dash, B dash, C dash. Now draw the projections and you will get the top view A, B, C. Now here B is in brackets. Why? If you see from the top here, A is above and B is below. So B will be hidden or not visible. And A is visible because A is above the B or B is below the A. So that's that is the reason we are putting B inside the brackets. So this is the first step. It is very simple. So next step is to give the inclination to the surface. Now the surface is inclined to VP. So in which view we will see the inclination? If any plane is inclined to VP, as we discussed in the first discussion, in the top view you will see the inclination. So we have to visualize that, then we can understand that the top view you will see the inclination, and that inclination is 45 degrees. So this is the top view. So it is a 45 degree line. And what is the length of this line? The length of this line is equal to this line AC. Here this line and this line are equal in length. Now after doing this, you drop the projections. So you got the projections and you draw the locus lines. And then you join the intersections. And the intersections are named as A1 dash, B1 dash and C1 dash. This is the second step. So what we have done here, we have given the surface some inclination. So because of that, what is happening is the front view of the object is reduced in shape size. Okay, you see this is a longer one and this is a smaller one. And this line, because it is perpendicular to HP, this line is not changed in dimension. Okay, so this next one, next step is to give the other inclination. So what is the other inclination? The longest side is AB, which is in VP, is making an angle of 30 degrees to HP. So if this line AB is making an angle of 30 degrees to HP, then that angle will be visible in front view. So in front view, you draw a 30 degree line, and then you construct this reduced triangle here. So what is the length of this line? It is A dash B1 dash, A1 dash B1 dash. So on this line, 30 degree line, what we will do? We will mark A1 dash B1 dash. What is this distance? This is equal to the same distance, A1 dash B1 dash. Now from these two points, you will draw two arcs equivalent to A1 dash C1 dash from A1 and B1 dash C1 dash from B1 dash. So intersection, you will get C1 dash. Now if you drop the projections here and you draw the locus lines, you will get points. So here the locus line from here and the projection from A is intersecting here, so you will get A1 here. Now here the locus line from B and projection from B is intersecting, so you will get B1 dash, B1. And here the locus line from here and the projection from here is getting intersected, so you will get C1 here. So you join all these points. So this is a very simple question, and here we have taken a triangle. This can be a pentagon, hexagon, square, rectangle, circle, anything it can be. So similar questions can be asked. So here this is a basic question. Directly they have given the inclination of the plane with VP. Now some cases the inclination will not be given. See in this case, a hexagonal lamina has its one side in VP and its opposite side, hexagonal lamina has its opposite side (25 mm) in front of VP and in HP. So here there is no mention of angles here, only the position of the other side is given. If you see a hexagon, you will see two sides parallel. See here, this side is parallel to this side, or this side is parallel to this side, this side is parallel to this side. So any set of sides we can take, and one side is in VP and the other side is in HP, and the condition is one side is 25 mm in front of VP. The side which is in HP is 25 mm in front of VP. So this question you can draw in side view also, but we will discuss with the traditional one, the three position method. So the first step, if the surface is inclined to VP or any part of the plane is resting in VP, then we will keep it parallel to VP. But here how to decide whether it is inclined to VP or not? Here the plane, one side is in VP and the other side is 25 mm in front of VP. Okay, so that means one side is nearer to VP, the other side is away from the VP, so it is plane inclination with VP. So first step is we have to keep it parallel to VP, and if we keep it parallel to VP, we will see the true shape of the hexagon in front view. So the front view can be drawn like this. After drawing the projections, you will get the topic. Now you may get a doubt whether the hexagon should be drawn like this or drawn like this. If the corner of the hexagon is in VP, then we will draw like this. But here the case is the edge or one side is in VP. So this is the correct one. We'll not consider the second option because this is corresponding to the question wherein the corner of the hexagon is in VP. Okay. So next step. Now we have decided this is the correct step. The side is perpendicular to XY because this side is in VP. We have to keep this side perpendicular to XY. So next one is to give the inclination of the surface, but in the question they have not mentioned any information about the angle. What they have mentioned is the edge AB is in VP and edge DE is 25 mm in front of VP. So you draw a line at a distance of 25 mm from XY and from there you draw a line. This point is AB and from AB with a distance of AE, this line distance from AB, you from A or B, here this is point A or B, from here you will draw a line, draw an arc onto this line which is at a distance of 25 mm from XY and the length of this arc is equal to AE. Okay, now this length and this length is equal. That should be, that we should be careful. Here we are just transferring these lengths here. We are not changing the lengths. We are only changing the orientation of this line. So next one is draw the projections, draw the locus lines, identify the intersection points and we will get the front view. So again, how to identify the intersection points? Locus line from A, projection from A, intersection will give A1 dash, locus line from F dash and projection from F will give F1 dash and so on. So in that way you have to identify the intersection points. Now the second point is done, second step is also over. Now what we have to do, what is given? The other edge, what is the other edge? One edge AB is in VP. Okay, so this point is in XY. Now this point DE is in HP. So here it is not in HP. So we have to keep it in HP. So how to do it? If any line is in HP, then in front view you will see that line on XY. So here you see, so this line E1 dash D1 dash is on XY. So what we have done, A1 dash B1 dash we have kept on VP, you can see here. Now in front view if you see E1 dash D1 dash is on XY, so it is in HP. So the second condition also fulfilled. Now what we have to do, you drop the projections from this and then draw the locus lines from this and identify the intersection points and our question is completed. So this is the way we have to approach this question. So here no inclination is given. Only thing is given is edge AB is in HP and DE edge is 25 mm in front of VP and also in HP. That is the question. So we have done that. A rhombus of diagonals 40 mm and 70 mm long respectively has one end of its longer diagonal is in VP. Okay, the longer diagonal has one end is in VP and it is so placed that its front view is a square of 40 mm diagonals. So the rhombus having 40 mm and 70 mm diagonals, but the front view you will see a square of 40 mm diagonals. So here also the surface inclination is not mentioned. Only thing they have mentioned is the size of the reduced front view they have given. So in the past two questions we have seen, if the surface is inclined to VP, the front view you will see a reduced shape. So here the reduced shape information is given and that is in front view. So first we will keep it parallel to VP and then draw the question. Now the rhombus is for 70 mm by 40 mm. So the diagonal AC is 70 mm and diagonal BD is 40 mm. Draw the projections and complete the top view. So this is the first step. So again here B is inside brackets because B is below D, so B is not visible, so we are keeping it inside brackets. So second step is they have mentioned the size of the front view, reduced front view, so that we will incorporate. Now the size of the reduced front view is 40 mm by 40 mm. So this is A1 dash, B1 dash, C1 dash, D1 dash. So this is the information that they have given. From this, what we have to identify? We have to identify what is the angle. So how to do that? Drop the projections and then on this projections, this point is in VP. A is in VP. So this point is in VP and now C position we have to identify. So take the distance AC and from here you draw an arc here. You will get ABCD. So what is this distance? AC distance is nothing but here AC distance. This AC distance we are taking and we are drawing here from A onto the projection of C, you will get this line. So this is the way you have to identify the inclination of the surface. So inclination of the surface is identified. If you it is asked what determine the inclination, you have to mention here compulsorily, otherwise you don't have to mention here the angle. So the next step is very simple. Here the next step, the front view of the longer diagonal. What is the longer diagonal? A dash C dash and its front view is A1 dash and C1 dash. This front view A1 dash C1 dash is making an angle of 40 degrees with HP. So draw a line at an angle of 40 degrees with HP. On that you put A1 dash and C1 dash and you identify the position of B1 dash and B1 dash. How to identify? This is A1 dash, this is C1 dash. From A1 dash you draw an arc with a distance of A1 B1 dash, A1 dash B1 dash, and from C1 dash you draw an arc with a distance of B1 dash C1 dash. You will get B1 dash. Similarly, a1 dash d1 dash distance, from here you draw an arc. c1 dash d1 dash distance, from here you draw another arc. You will get d1 dash. Once you got these things, pretty simple. You draw projections. Projections are drawn. Now draw the locus lines. Locus lines are drawn. Now identify the intersection points and then draw the lines. So this is very simple. Only ambiguity is how to get this inclination. Many people will do mistake here only. So we should be very careful. Here, this is the rhombus. Its front view is a square. So draw the rhombus in parallel to VP, because here the front view is front view size is reduced. So front view rhombus, big construct a rhombus, draw the projections on that. You draw the dimensions 40 by 40 square. From there draw projections and complete the question. So very simple. So next one, fourth question. A circle of 50 mm diameter has end A in VP. One of its diameter AC, which is 45 degrees inclined to HP, while it makes an angle of 30 degrees with VP. So inclination with it is making, the diagonal AC is inclined to both HP and VP. So here, but here the end A is in VP. So what we'll do, we'll start with the VP condition. So if the plane is in VP, first thing is you keep it parallel to VP, draw the projections, and then give the inclination. So the inclination of AC with VP is visible in top view. So you are given inclination here. Now you draw the projections, draw the locus lines, and identify the intersection points and complete the front view. So up to here it is similar to what we have done previously. Now the next step is inclination to HP. Inclination of AC to HP, how to incorporate that here? That is the question. Now it is similar to the fourth question, the previous discussion. First, we have to identify A dash C dash inclination is given. You have to identify what is the inclination of A1 dash C1 dash. So first, A dash C dash distance, with that distance and with the given inclination, you draw a line. So what is this line length? This line length is A dash C dash, and the inclination is 45. Now from that end, you draw the locus line. You draw a locus line here. Then with A dash C dash distance, you draw an arc here. Okay, what is the length of this smaller line? It is A1 dash C1 dash. Now on that, you construct your this A1 dash B1 dash C1 dash D1 dash. This circle we have to construct here. But we have to take more number of points here, because if you draw with the free hand, you will not get with 4 points. So you will take at least 8 or 12 points to get a proper diagram. Now, so this one we have done. How A1 dash C1 dash you got based on A1 dash C1 dash, You identify the position of the remaining points of the ellipse, drawing arcs and intersecting, and you will get this ellipse. Okay. So next step is draw the projections. From here it is simple. Only thing here is we have to identify what is the inclination of this A1 dash C1 dash. That is the important thing here. So the step is, first you draw a line at 45 degrees and the length of the line is equal to A dash C dash. Now from the end you draw a locus line, and from there, from A1 dash, you cut an arc with a distance of A1 dash C1 dash. You will get A1 dash C1 dash. Based on A1 dash and C1 dash, you construct the remaining points. Next is, you drop the projections and draw the locus lines, identify the intersection points and complete the ellipse. Now here, if you have only 4 points, you will not be able to get this curve, which is outside these 4 points. So minimally 8 points, if possible 12 points we have to take on this circle, and then you drop this things. So this, the crucial thing is to identify what is the angle made by A1 dash C1 dash. If you get that thing, then question is very simple. So here the inclination of diameter AC with HP and VP is given. So what we have done, we have given the inclination of VP, and then we have identified the inclination of the front view of the diagonal, and then we have completed the question. So that is the procedure. Next one, a different type of question. An isosceles triangle of 40 mm side. An isosceles triangle of 40 mm long base side, 60 mm long altitude, is freely suspended from one corner of the base side. Its plane is 45 degrees inclined to VP. Draw its projections. That is the question. So what is this freely suspended? So freely suspended means, if you hang a plane holding any point on the circumference freely, if you leave it, then the point on the circumference which you are holding and the line joining that point with this centroid of the plane will be perpendicular to HP. So first step is to identify the centroid of the plane. So you draw the plane and identify the position of the centroid of the plane. So AG is the line joining centroid. If we are suspending freely with A, then the line AG is our focus now. Now once you identify the point G, which is the centroid of the plane, the next step is to keep that AG perpendicular to HP. Now if the plane is inclined to VP, so first step is to keep it parallel to VP. So and we have to keep AG perpendicular to HP. So AG is perpendicular to HP. Now based on this AG, you construct the remaining triangle. So how to draw it? You take distances of A dash, B dash, G dash, B dash, you draw two arcs, you get B dash. Similarly, A dash, C dash, you draw an arc, this A, C, and C, G distance, C dash, G dash distance, you draw another arc, you will get C dash. So, if you get this one, then the remaining thing is very simple. Drop the projections and you will get a line, because it is parallel to VP, you will get a line parallel to XY. So, next step is to give the inclination of the surface. So, inclination of the surface, the position of AG should not change. So, that is the only thing we have to identify. So, AG, we have to keep in same line, and you draw a line, you draw this line BC at an angle of 45 degrees. Okay, you draw a line at an angle of 45 degrees, identify AG, and from there you identify BC. So, these distances and these distances are same. So, BA, AC, all these distances are same here. From this diagram, distances are not modified. Only thing is, here it is parallel, we are making it inclined at an angle of 45 degrees. Next, you drop projections from here, and then draw the locus lines from the immediate front view, and you identify the intersection points, you will get the final front view. So, this is the final solution. Only thing that we have to new is identifying this line AG. Here, that is the only thing. Otherwise, it is a simple question, but people find it difficult because this concept, the line joining A and centroid should be perpendicular to XY. That thing, if we know, then the question is very simple. Thank you. We'll meet again.